5-Minute Fridays with Jonathan Paula. Hello and welcome to the show. My name is Jonathan Paula. As for what I've been working on, as promised, retrofitting or just regular fitting, outfitting my office with lights. I had to get up on the ladder, do a good deal of staple work, which as you may or may not know, is not really my forte, getting on ladders and hammering things. I did 3 years of construction with my father, but none of that rubbed off. Not really a hands-on guy, more of a technical computer. You get where I'm going. Anyway, so I mounted them on the ceiling, run the wires, it's all plugged in, it's connected to a light switch, it's excellent. But just as I'm filming this video, I'm realizing now that the lighting on me in the background, I feel like I want to turn the background lights off when I do desk videos because I don't, that's too bright. Like this is all too bright right now. So, but unfortunately they're all on the same circuit and I can't reach any of this room is too tall. I physically cannot reach the lights unless I get on like an 8-foot ladder. Even standing on my desk, it's not tall enough. It's a big room. So maybe I'll fix that. By next 5-Minute Fridays, maybe I'll have the front light and the back lights on separate switches so we can do one or the other. As for what's in the news this week, EgyptAir Flight 804, unfortunately coming to a watery grave in the Mediterranean early Thursday morning. It blipped off radar after sort of spiraling out of control. New information and data from the cockpit recorders, whatever, indicated that there was some smoke and a lot of sensors going off, and then it just quickly sort of went into a spiral, and they found some debris earlier today, so we know definitively it's crashed. But the big question is, was it terrorism, or was it some sort of explosive decompression, a fire in the cabin, something? I feel like obviously the first and obvious sort of assumption is yes, it was a bomb on board, some form of terrorism. And it also seems to be the kind that incapacitated the crew immediately because they didn't have a chance to signal Mayday or anything. So I'm going to keep an eye on this. I am a huge airline, like air crash buff. I read up on all the disasters. I'm a big fan of the show Mayday, also called Air Crash Investigation. And my time in college, I would spend hours just reading Wikipedia pages about all the different airlines. I don't know why it fascinates me, but whatever. And speaking of airlines, earlier today I uploaded my long-awaited American Airlines rant. I had this terrible, awful, no good, very bad experience with them last fall, and I finally got around to getting and finding the footage. I lost it for a bit, you know, I was between homes, and I put the video together, and I was happy with the way it came out. I'm really angry and frustrated in the video, but it was filmed the day of, and I think that's sort of, it captured my mood perfectly then. Today, I have a distance, a perspective on the situation. I've mellowed out a bit.
It was so much fucking shit compounding on top of other shit. You had a pile of shit the size of Mount fucking Everest at the end of this day.
I saw all the news this week about airlines, both long TSA lines and then the Egyptian air crash, and I was like, I should just upload this now while everyone's talking about airlines. And I guess that paid off. It got some traction on Reddit, and as of recording, the video is up to 45,000 views in just a few hours, which for me, despite my lofty and irrelevant subscriber number, is actually a really solid get for me, so that's great. But what pissed me off is just the rhetoric and the vitriol and the hateful just name-calling. Like, okay, I had a bad travel experience. Maybe some of it was on me. I didn't get to the airport, you know, 3 hours early. I only got there an hour early. But some people are just name-calling and really, like, again, we've been over this before. Like, I'm a real person. I read these things. I read all of these things. I'm obsessed with reading comments. It's an addiction, I know. But when people call me names like moron, cunt, asshole, entitled douchebag, like it legitimately does hurt my feelings. Especially since I don't feel like any of it was warranted. Like American Airlines totally fucking screwed the pooch on this. And yet people are trying to spin it around like it was my problem or that I'm somehow not allowed to complain about it. Like, oh, you're just entitled. Like, fuck you. I have a platform. I have an audience. I had a terrible experience and I want to tell people about it. Not just to, you know, tell you not to use this particular service, but also just because it's an entertaining story and that's what I do. I tell stories on the internet. It bothers me that this stuff pissed me. Like, you would think a video going viral would be like a great occasion, but it's not. Like, it puts knots in my stomach. I dread it because I just get this wave of assholes commenting on my stuff. I like the small little tight-knit community we have here without all the Reddit hive mind jerks. But I had a cool video and some questions I was going to answer, but rather than try to edit this down, we'll just call it a night right there. Thank you for watching and listening. My name is John, and I'll see you right back here next Friday.